Why is e the natural number? This is a burning question many math students have had over the years, and for good reason. It shows up everywhere from finance, biology, and anything that involves exponential growth. But that begs another question. Why does this seemingly random, irrational number show up in so many unconnected places? By the end of this video, I'm going to answer both those questions and hopefully change your understanding of exponential growth from just another function you learn in school to something that truly shows why e is natural and why it shows up everywhere. Let's begin our journey by reviewing a bit of what we already know. Generally, exponential equations take this form where you raise some constant to some independent variable. For now, we'll act like this constant is 2. And this is typically where most students' exploration of exponential functions stops, as they go on to learn about logarithms and how they can be used to algebraically solve for x. But what I want to do is take a step back and ask this question: what makes exponential functions distinct? Or in other words, why is this type of function different from others that look similar to it, like this quadratic? If you know some calculus, you can probably provide an answer. And if you want, I'd like to hear your opinion on what makes exponential functions unique in the comments. But for those that have no idea where to start, I'd like to introduce you to something called a derivative. While it may have an intimidating name, the main idea behind the derivative is elegantly simple. Essentially, what a derivative does is it allows us to express the slope of a function at any point on the curve by asking this question. As we take smaller and smaller steps along the x-axis, how much does the resulting y-value change? In terms of a formula, this is what that statement translates to, and it's the key to unlocking why exponential functions are unique. Also, as a quick side note for those of you that want to learn math and have a hard time reading these denser-looking formulas or notation, I believe that finding ways to translate them into a more human-readable sentence is a great way to quickly improve your understanding of what you're looking at and why the math behind it makes sense. Back to our definition for a derivative though. If we take the two functions we want to compare and put them through our formula, we get expressions that define their slopes. We can then simplify these expressions to gain some insight into how our functions are different, and what we find is incredibly useful. What these new expressions tell us is that, for our quadratic, its slope at any point is 2 times the x value of that point. But for our exponential function, its slope at any point is some constant times the y value of that point. If I were to translate that into a sentence, I would say, as the value of an exponential function increases, its slope or growth increases proportionally by some constant. This right here is why the exponentials are unique. No other family of functions has this proportional growth. And by understanding the inner mechanism of how this type of growth works, we get a lot closer to understanding e. To show you why, let's examine the derivative of our exponential a bit more closely. More specifically, let's look at our constant, because if we expand it out into this form, we can find some pretty useful information. If you have keen eyes, you might recognize that this constant is determined by the base of our exponent. To show you what I mean, this is what the growth constant looks like for the numbers 1 through 10. And here's what they look like on a graph, where they seem to taper off as the number increases. Upon seeing this behavior of our constant, mathematicians wanted to answer one question. What is the number that results in a growth constant of 1? This question wasn't easy to answer, and it took until the 17th century just to approximate it. But after many years of searching, one Swiss mathematician, Leonhard Euler, found the answer. And his answer was the irrational number 2.71828182845, or more commonly known as e for Euler's number. And this discovery is what makes e the natural number. Because it's the only number with an exponential growth constant of 1, we can neatly express any other exponential functions in terms of e. And what that means is that for any process in the universe where the growth of something is proportional to its current value, like population growth, compound interest, or even the half-life of atoms, e will be there, almost as if it's a part of nature. So that's why it's the natural number, and why it shows up seemingly everywhere.